Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. The last character to try out here, Doctor. I don't play as him very much, so I completely forgot how he plays. But I guess we're gonna see in World 6, as I said in the last part, this is my favorite world of all time. Well, okay, just in this game. Awesome music, quirky design, very, very bright as well, may I add. And you can jump across those platforms to get bananas onto the other side, but I'm not even gonna bother doing that. I'm just gonna carefully work my way up through here like that. Don't go too fast, otherwise you'll fly out into the abyss, and he's not that hard to control at all. He feels a lot like AiAi, actually, in terms of controls, so I can work with him. With this one, you've got some elevators of sorts, ring donut elevators or something like that. It's not donut blocks from Mario here, it's donut elevators exclusive to monkeys. And there you go, just jump on it like that, and then you'll be going all the way up to the top, and get ready to transfer over to the next one, which is a much thinner one, but it's still very easy to stay on top of it. Just push against the wall, and then when you get to the top, there's gonna be some rails to go down. See these things here? Wait. Oh, his jump is really low. I guess that's the difference between him and AiAi, as his jump is that low. That's okay. I hope. Yeah. Oh, yeah! That was a really close one, though. Yeah, his jump is a lot lower, so compensate for what you've seen there by jumping earlier than I did. That might be very handy for this stage, though. It's another one of those ones that you have to stay inside the rings for the whole duration of the ride, and there's no bumpers in these, but they're thinner, and you have to transfer from one to another, and there's holes in between them. It's quite the issue, actually. I had a lot of trouble on my first run through on this game with this stage, especially when I was attempting to perfect the stages to get gold crowns and unlock World 9 and 10. All right. Yeah, oh, no, I need to get on there. Use the backboard. First one's easy to get on, actually. The next ones are, oh my. Okay, get ready to move to the left. And use the upslope. Get your rhythm back. Like, get back and forth, oh, poopers. That was terrible on my end. What I was trying to do was control my jump by jumping into the upslope of the next one so that I would have a more predictable landing. Because you see, if you try and aim for the flat part of the center, it's not flat, it's round. I mean, it's completely round, so it's hard to tell if you're going to bounce left or right. So what you want to do is aim for an upslope or a downslope so that you can predict where you're going to roll inside these rings. Come on, you can do it. I know you can do it. Come on. See, as I said, you can just use the backboard to control yourself on this one, but the other ones, they're spaced more, and you can't really do that. Maybe you'd have an easier time with GonGon, because he's huge, and he wouldn't fit in those gaps. Okay, I'm gonna just transfer like that. And also, try to avoid touching the red edges of these rings, because they have a little lip to them, and as I said before, the lips are the bane of your existence because of the fact that they will bounce you right out of whatever you're on. So, whoa! Okay, now this is going to get in the way of the camera, so this is going to be really weird and probably show up very badly in the recording, because the camera's not going to be able to keep up with such speed and it's going to look choppy, but that's okay, you just have to jump off to the left, and there you go. Woo! And next stage. Oh, this is a flip panel one. I really like this one. It's an easy stage, but it's crazy. You just have to get your jumps to go just above these thingies. Oh, that's right. The doctor is a terrible jumper. Oh my, maybe this isn't gonna be a lot harder than I thought it would be. As I said in the last part, I recommend YanYan for everything, actually, so if you're using her for this stage, you won't have much trouble. Okay, I think I gotta do it like that. I gotta use them like bounce off the ones that are moving upwards to try and get him to get a little more jump height. I gotta do it here. Yeah! I didn't think I'd be able to make that, but I did, and that makes me happy. There's some bananas up over here, if you care for them, but I really don't. Because there's those bumpers over there, and I don't really feel like risking them after playing this slightly risky stage. Bonus day! Oh, man. I just can't fake enthusiasm with these. So we got this one here. You want to try and control your jumps to get the bananas without falling off the edge. But you're very likely to fall off the edge on this one, actually, because of the way it tilts. Oh, dear. So maybe this bonus stage isn't really worth attempting to get 20 bananas on to at least get one up, I don't know. You might just be better off waiting to run out of time, but then I don't know, I'm doing pretty well here, actually. Keep up the rhythm, don't fall into... I was gonna say, where's the last one? Oh, that tilts off on those angles, so that means I have to get up using... Oh dear. Oh my, oh goodness gracious, great balls of fire. Eh, there we go. Did a lot better than I expected I would. Next stage, number 5. Some platforming, some rails. We've done all this stuff before in so-and-so different ways, and I tried to get a little speed by bouncing off the edge there. I don't think it worked very well. I'm going to carefully work my way down these rails. Slow down when you get to a corner. That should be pretty obvious. His voice is hilarious, by the way. And get ready to get as much speed as you possibly can. Don't lose control! Oh, no! That is just tragic. He hopped up right at the last second and bounced off the top of the ring. Whoa! I almost died there. That would be okay. It's not that hard of a stage other than that last part where you need the control. And there we go. Okay, so this time, stay with better control. Yeah! First run was pretty good, except for that random, odd, shaky bounce at the end there. But that just happens sometimes. Alright, we got some mushroom platforming here. This is not Super Mario Brothers, in case you're confused. But the concept is pretty much the same. just wait for a platform to be underneath you before you jump over to the next platform. Otherwise, you're gonna be... Oh! Especially with the doctor! Otherwise, you're gonna be really risking having low jumps and not having control like I had there. But I was really rushing, alas. That is my weakness, is my impatience. That's what actually gave me a lot of trouble when I was, as I said, trying to gold crown the levels of this game to unlock the final two worlds. Because a lot of these stages are about patience and timing things properly. See, you don't have any trouble with this whatsoever if you just take your time. But sometimes I just get antsy. And there's a thin jump coming right here. So get yourself centered. And carefully. Good! Woo! One stage left. Wait, I thought it was on 7. Oh, this one is really fun. Do not hesitate. Do not wait. You don't have time to wait. You only have 30 seconds to get to the end of this very long track. Keep pushing forward and tilt yourself in the direction that the slopes are leaning towards. So see, this one's going to the right, so you lean towards the right while tilting the Wii Remote forward. And you'll have control all the way up to the end without worrying about falling off. And I just said without worrying about falling off. That, I swear, that never happened to me before. I'm slightly devastated. Let's try this again. Perhaps he goes a lot faster than... Like, I always typically use... Well, not always. I typically use YanYan. And she has less speed. So maybe that was the thing. I don't know. Anyway, get ready to jump soon. Like, right over here. Wait, seriously?
Did that work?
I seriously thought I didn't make it. I'll take it! this is like that pirate one where you had the moving platforms that you had to time to get yourself across. You want to get yourself over to... Whoa, not there. Well, not on top of that thing. Get yourself over to here. Dash the edge. There you go. And... let's navigate over to this one. This one's a lot more strict than timing. Get it. Okay. Then I think you go this way. I'm trying to look around with the camera here. That's why I got so close to the edge trying to whip it around. And I think you have to go off to the right when you get up here. No, it's left. I should have just waited for it to go back down and then come back up again rather than jump the gun. And that was a wonderful run too. Now I have to deal with the timing once again. But that's okay, I think I can do it. I did it once before and you've just seen it. And good! One more. Bing boom boo do 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 do. So cheery, so jazzy, awesome music, fits Monkey Ball perfectly. Alright, get ready to move to your left. Beautiful. Woo! Now for the boss, which again I don't remember in the slightest. Hopefully it's not going to give me any trouble. Oh, it's Opera Lady. With a very large bosom and a microphone. Apparently the microphone hurts her. Maybe it hurts her at her very soul, you know, her music. Get near the edge, actually. So when she does her sound effect thing, what she'll do is she'll push you into the wall and won't blast you too far. When is she going to drop her microphone to get lower so I can jump at her with... Wait, there, right there. Ugh, perfect. Must repeat. Yeah, I remember her now. Alright, do your opera once again, lady. Good girl. And then drop your mic so I can get to it. Oh. Oh, wow. Her voice brings down the house. Let's try it again. We have no other choice but to do so. Can I actually hit her when she's over? Oh, I can bump these things out from underneath her. Ah, so that's how you get her lower. I was overcomplicating things all along. That makes things like 800 times easier, because now I can hit the microphone when it's down there, and yeah. Somehow I'm staying on the stage. It looks like she's like some sort of spirit or something like that. You'll notice that it's got those like spirit balls around her and stuff like that. So maybe she's a part of the undead or something like that. I don't know. Oh, do not. No! Freaking Jesus! How dare you knock me off the stage twice in a row? Or at least I got a challenge out of a boss this time. I just noticed that there's a little heart on her stage. Nice little bit of detail I thought I would point out there. Can I hit? Yeah, I can hit it when it's like that. I could speed things up greatly then if I just... Maybe I should be more towards the center or something like that. Oh, she stuns you and you can't jump. So that's why I wasn't able to avoid the rocks when I was trying to jump around them, or jump over them, excuse me. So when she sings on you, that stuns you and... Whoa! And then you can't avoid... Like, I should say you can't control yourself as easily. And I have to hit her 5 times without falling off. I have a feeling this is slightly luck-based. I do not approve of this. And why are they bouncing so much? Alright, one more hit. Just rush in and just get it. Get it done. Get her done. There we go. And that's it. She's a pretty funny lady, though, I have to admit. And that's the end of World 6. And this part. I'll see how I place with my score and whatnot, just for the heck of it. I'm gonna, click through that. We've seen that cutscene a lot lately. Every single part. No credits, no! Stop, no! Oh, no high score this time. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this part, and I will see you in the next part.